Alright y'all, welcome to attempt number 3 at me trying to film this video. So as you can see from where I'm standing, today's video is going to be a campus tour. So let's get started. And here comes campus police. Probably asking me, about to get ready to ask me what I'm doing. So, hope I'm not shaking too much. Trying to be as still as possible. Alrighty, so this is a map, typical map, one which like you will see whenever you're on Xavier's campus. They have them all over the place. So as you can see by the little Target, we are right here at the corner, I guess you could say, yeah, of the admin building, which is building number 1, and St. Joe's, which is building number 2. So I'm going to take you from building 1 to building 10, and then we're going to go through 36 and all that other stuff. Now you see V61, all that down there, that's actually across the street, and I'm not trying to get hit this early on your Sunday morning, so I'm not going to show you guys that. But I don't even know if they show you guys on a regular tour, but I think I'm gonna try to include pictures. So let's go. All right, so we're walking up on building number 1. This is the admin building. You will have your English, some math, freshman seminar, I think maybe philosophy class this year as well, and they're doing construction, so gotta be careful. But I really wanted to show y'all the entrance to it with the steps, because when I tell you it's so beautiful, it's ridiculous. Right, and if y'all ever have seen people take pictures in front of this Xavier thing, this is where it's at. So, like I'm seeing, administration building, English classes, all that other good stuff. Got these beautiful steps that lead up to this doorway. I'm not quite sure if people enter the doors, but people take pictures in front of this a lot, so yeah. As we're walking, that big green thing up there at the top is the pedestrian bridge, and then the little brown one is another pedestrian bridge for us to cross the street to go to the Convocation Center, which has the big roofs, and that's the Convocation Annex, I'm sorry, and then the Convocation Center with the green glass. And then this right here is the entrance to the admin building that most people usually take. Got the administration auditorium and all that other good stuff. So yeah, so walking along, I'm about to take y'all to the music building, the front entrance of that as well. Oof. Y'all, I really hope this video is not shaky, because when I tell y'all I filmed this yesterday morning with my camera, my Canon, and I thought I was not moving that much, but it was terrible. But that's the music building. Now we're about to go to NTF, the Norman T. Francis Science Complex / Academic Center. We have a new side and an old side. The old side is where your lab classes will be and where your teacher, school professor's offices will be. And the new side is where your foundations classes will be. New side has 5 floors. First floor is the first year bio labs. Second floor is IT, plus computer engineering, chemical engineering, and physics. Third floor is chemistry. Fourth floor, bio. Fifth floor, math. Yeah. And then this is the new side that we're walking up on. Once again, this building right here is the music building. And then into the old side of the inside. So if you are any type of science STEM major, your life will be in this building. Literally. Like, out of my 9 classes that I have, 6 of them are in here. So, we have the name right up there. It is also coupled with the pharmacy building, which you'll see the entrance to that in a few. But this is the library. It has 6 floors. Some classes are on the 5th floor. We have this thing where each floor has a special thing about it, like the 2nd floor is a collaboration floor, 3rd floor is the quiet floor. So they have a lot of individual cubicles for you to be in, and then the 4th floor is the silent zone. So it is the library and bike rack. Davis campus really isn't that big to where you would need a bike rack, in my personal opinion, but for a lot of people that live in the South Campus, which we'll see in a couple minutes, they prefer to ride bikes to class. So, beautiful pathway. I walk it every day. Very nice. A lot of times you'll see the squirrels. The squirrels, they're chill. Real quick, let me show y'all this thing right here. I'm not quite sure what it is, but it moves. And it has words engraved in it on the granite at the bottom. But they personally don't make sense to me. It's like a whole bunch of sentence fragments kind of thrown together. And right there, as you can see, we got the big tree, a couple benches. A lot of times during the school day, you'll see students studying, hanging out right there. Then you also see like these little random cement benches strewn throughout. And I apologize because it is about to be bright. So I mean, I'll probably try to split this clip so that it's not as bright, so that you can see it. But this is one of the entrances right here to the College of Pharmacy. Like I said, it's in technically the same building as the library. 2 separate entrances. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Xavier's Pharmacy School, but they have this PharmD program. It's like a dual degree. You spend 2 years in undergrad, 4 years in pharmacy school. You graduate with a PharmD and you can become a pharmacist on graduating from Xavier. All right, now 2 things. Right next to the pharmacy school, that's the front entrance, those steps over there. Right here we have the chapel, St. Catherine Drexel Chapel. We have mass here on Sundays at 1, or maybe 12, I don't know, but it's the chapel, it's really nice inside. And then that building that you see right there is St. Mike's. It is the freshman girls' dorm. Also, okay, so if you do decide to come to Xavier and you live on campus and you don't have a parking pass, you see how there are cars parked in front of the dorm. You are allowed to park there for free. Also, there are many parking lots here at Xavier, but honestly, most of them are for faculty, so there's that. But you are allowed to park in this little parking lot. You can't see it. After 5 on Fridays till 5 a.m. on Mondays, students are allowed to park there. Free of charge, no ticket. Right in that building, behind the parking lot, I'm not quite sure what it is, but real quick, this is KD. You've seen the tour of KD. Behind that is St. Joe's. That is the office of CESO. So CESO makes sure you're retaining satisfactory academic progress so that, you know, you don't get on academic probation, lose a scholarship, stuff like that. There's a lot of different offices in there. Offices of Multicultural Affairs. You have the office that deals with like study abroad, office for undergraduate research. You also have a tutoring center. You have like the math tutoring center, writing tutoring center. Yeah, and what else? They have counseling services in there as well. Walk in front of KD. Walk into the CAF. The CAF is extremely close, as you can see. It's called the UC, the University Center. We have 3 different quote-unquote restaurants. We have Jasmine's, which is a coffee and bagel place, I guess you could call it. Sub Connection, which is like Subway. And then Flambeau's, which sells po' boys. That's what I get from there. They got hot wings, things like that. And then those stairs, I'm not sure how well you can see them, but that leads up to the terrace, yeah, leads to the terrace. Alrighty, now, to keep walking. So as you can see, at least I think you can see, there are these houses in between Xavier's campus, and that is kind of what differentiates Xavier from a traditional college campus. There are houses. These three red houses right here to my left are for the nuns, but the other random houses, I'm not sure if Xavier owns them and regular people live in them, but regular people do live in the houses. So please be careful when you're walking down our quote-unquote sidewalk. But where I'm taking you right now are the last four quote-unquote main buildings on campus. We have the LLC dorm, which is a sophomore girls dorm, which we'll see in a few. We also have Xavier South, which is home to the Office of Financial Aid, also the Office of Fiscal Services. So those are the people that handle all the university's money. We have the gym, and we have St. Martin de Porres, which is where sophomore boys and then junior girls will live. Also the basketball players, both girls and boys live there. And yeah, that's basically it. Like I was saying earlier, I am not going to show you the Convocation Center or the Convocation Annex because I'm really not trying to walk across the street. But I mean, it is really nice inside. So, like I said, y'all, random houses. And I mean, I will apologize real quick, because I did not go inside the buildings. But I mean, whenever you do come to visit, they'll take you inside and let you get a gist of everything. And once again, I really hope this video is stable, because I refuse to film it a fourth time. Look how quiet it is. I love it. Nice and chill. Not much really happens on campus. Like, I'm not a huge party person myself, but there are shuttles and like party buses that'll come pick students up every Friday. I'm not sure about Saturdays, but they'll have a shuttle that comes to Xavier at one time and then goes to Dillard at another time, and it'll bring you to the party. Also, you know how like you see the party promoters on Twitter? They'll actually be on campus. Ooh, somebody's in trouble. Look at that. See the flashing lights down there? But they'll actually bring students. I'm tripping, y'all. They'll be on campus handing out flyers for their parties. Yada, yada, yada. Okay, I'm gonna come through here. So, yeah, more houses. This beautiful building right here is BP that I was telling you. Sophomore boys, junior girls, basketball players. I'm gonna have to walk a little bit closer for you to see the gym, but right here with the three towers is what I call it, is Xavier South. You got Fiscal Services, Financial Aid, Psychology Department, Sociology Department. I'm not really not sure what else. And I'm all out of breath. I need to get in shape, y'all. You still can't see it. I would have to go a little bit closer. Walking through the parking lot. Okay. You see the little white building right there, triangle structure. That is the gym, state of the art. And then right here, we have the LLC, sophomore girls. It's really nice inside. You do have your own bathroom. Compared to Katie, there'll be two people to a room as always, but those two people share a bathroom, essentially. That's like the only difference. I do have a friend that lives in there, so if y'all would want a tour, because there is a possibility that you'll be placed in there in the event that Katie runs out of space, you will be placed in there. So I mean, I can try to get a tour of that dorm if you guys would like to see that, but other than that, just let me know. But thank you guys for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment box below, and I will see you guys for homecoming, actually. So bye guys.